This is the evolution of iOS. The year 2007 marks the beginning of a revolution in technology. Apple releases its first mobile operating system, OS 1, with the original iPhone.
Today, Apple is going to reinvent the phone.
For younger viewers, it can be difficult to understand how revolutionary this operating system was at the time. Features like multi-touch screen, visual voicemail, and iTunes integration were major advancements. Pre-installed apps include Calendar, Photos, Camera, Notes, Safari, YouTube, Maps, Mail, Phone, and iPod. A year later, OS 2 brings a big change. The App Store, with around 500 apps available at launch. Other improvements include support for Microsoft Exchange, and later, the contact search function was also available. OS 3 brought essential functions such as copy, cut, paste, and support for MMS, the universal search function, push notifications, spotlight, voice control, but also video recording through the camera application, a notable function introduced in this version. A major change introduced in iOS 4 was the name iOS, replacing the previously used iPhone OS. Released in 2010, it introduces features widely used today, such as multitasking, FaceTime, iBooks, organizing apps into folders, HDR photos, personal hotspot, AirPlay, and AirPrint. iOS 5 makes the debut of iCloud, providing automatic storage and syncing for all Apple devices. They also debuted features that are now essentials, such as iMessage and Notification Center, and most importantly, the virtual assistant, Siri. With iOS 6, Apple ditched Google Maps in favor of its own Maps app, which had quite a few bugs. This led to the firing of the head of iOS development, Scott Forstall. iOS 6 also introduces Passbook, a precursor to Apple Wallet, for managing tickets, coupons, and boarding passes. At the same time, Facebook integration is added, making it easier to share content on the social network. The development of iOS 7 was overseen by Johnny Ive, Apple's head of design, who had previously worked only on hardware. However, iOS 7 has fussed about design and aesthetics.
With its edge-to-edge design, precise typography, when you swipe into the home screen, you get these gorgeous animations as these icons come in with their harmonious layout, their precisely chosen color palette.
With a completely reinvented interface, vibrant colors, and smooth transitions, iOS 7 offers a new and immersive visual experience. AirDrop has been introduced, Control Center provides quick access to essential settings, and CarPlay is introduced for better integration with cars. The most important feature of iOS 7 is Touch ID, which allows users to unlock their devices using their fingerprint. iOS 8 continues to expand the possibilities with features like HealthKit and HomeKit that makes the iPhone the center of health and smart home devices. iCloud Drive provides cloud storage and continuity, makes it possible to seamlessly switch between iPhone, iPad, and Mac, allowing users to start an activity on one device and continue it on another. Also, Apple introduced support for third-party widgets for the first time.
Finally, we're enabling third-party apps to define widgets that can now go in Notification Center.
And improvements were also made on the notification side, which allowed, for example, posting a comment on Facebook directly from the notification. iOS 9 brings stability and performance. For example, the low power mode function ensures the quality of the device's performance even if the battery is low, and Siri and advanced search have been combined to provide more accurate information. At the same time, new functions such as Night Shift were introduced, the Notes application has improved, and the Passbook application became Wallet and could be accessed from the unlock screen. iOS 10 reimagines many of the native apps. Messages become more expressive with stickers and effects, and Siri is open to third-party developers. Finally, the ability to delete built-in apps has been introduced. Also, the lock screen is redesigned, offering faster access to notifications and widgets, and the Photos application had an algorithmic search called Memories.
Let's talk about iOS 11.
iOS 11 brings increased power and functionality, especially to iPad, with a customizable dock and advanced multitasking features. Files, a new app, centralizes all user files in one place. Drag-and-drop support, split-screen apps, and multiple workspaces were introduced. Control Center is redesigned for customization and faster access to essential functions. The Siri application has a new voice.
Here's the forecast for the next 10 days. Sunny, sunny. and Sunny.
And can search and synchronize information on several devices, and Messages had a new function to be able to send money to friends through an iMessage using Apple Pay.
Well, our next big release of iOS is iOS 12.
iOS 12 focuses on performance and stability, especially in older devices like the iPhone 5S. Screen time has been introduced to help manage your screen time. Shortcuts, a new application, allows the creation of automated workflows with Siri, and with the Messages application had customizable animations called Memoji, and allowed users to create a 3D character. At the same time, notifications could be grouped and managed much better. For example, if the user receives 100 emails, they will be grouped and not displayed individually.
Yes, it's iOS 13.
iOS 13 brings a major change, namely that it no longer runs on the iPad because iPad OS was released specifically designed for the iPad. With iOS 13, dark mode becomes available, offering a new aesthetic and battery saving. Apple is making significant improvements to the Photos and Maps app with better organization and new editing features. The Find My app combines Find My iPhone and Find My Friends into one app, and Sign In with Apple provides a secure and private way to sign into apps and websites. iOS 13 also features improvements to app update times. App launch times are twice as fast, app downloads take 50% less time compared to the previous version, and Face ID is faster with 30%.
Our new release is iOS 14.
iOS 14 revolutionizes the home screen with customizable widgets and the app library, which automatically organizes apps in an easy-to-access way. Picture-in-picture enables true multitasking, app clips provide quick access to app functionality without fully installing them, and Messages get improvements with conversation pinning and mentions. As for the calls, they will have a completely new display mode, being much more compact.
Our new release is iOS 15.
iOS 15 brings a number of improvements for security, privacy, and functionality, especially in the context of the trend of remote work. One of the most notable changes is the FaceTime enhancement, which includes SharePlay. It also brings spatial audio for a more natural 3D audio experience.
I wish I could be there.
Me too. Let me fix this. Better, right?
Portrait mode brings background blur to video calls, and cross-platform support enables FaceTime calls on the web and Android. iOS 15 also introduces the Focus feature, which adds smart settings for notification and communication. The photo app is getting major improvements like live text and visual search. Other improvements include support for iCloud Plus, notification scheduling, summarization, improved direction in Maps, and a redesigned tab management experience in Safari. iOS 16 brings a new level of customization, allowing users to customize their lock screens with interactive widgets and custom themes. The possibility to edit and cancel the sending of messages sent via iMessage was also introduced. Apple Pay later introduces flexible payment options for shopping. The map function gets further improvements, and the focus mode is expanded, allowing even more detailed settings for various activities. With iOS 17, Apple has taken integration to a whole new level. One of the most notable changes in iOS 17 is the change in voice commands from Hey Siri to simple Siri, along with the ability to give consecutive commands to the voice assistant. This version also brings improvements to the phone, FaceTime, and Messages apps. AirDrop has been updated to include the name drop feature, which makes it easy to quick share contacts. iOS 17 introduces the Journal app, which provides an intuitive journaling experience based on photos, locations, contacts, music, podcasts, and more. Widgets become interactive, bringing functionality directly to the home screen. iOS 17 also includes a new feature called Standby, similar to the nightstand mode on the Apple Watch.
iOS 18 is a big release.
The latest iOS version continues to redefine and expand the iPhone's capabilities. iOS 18 introduces Apple Intelligence, an AI-based platform integrated with Siri and ChatGPT that enables advanced text and image generation, available on iPhone 15 Pro and later. Control Center is redesigned, offering extensive customization options for sizes and layouts, and the lock screen can be customized, including changing the default options like flashlight and camera. Home screen customization is also improved. The Mail app introduces message grouping, summarization, and new categories for more efficient management. Maps include topography, detail, and trail information. Messaging adds more tap-back options, text styles, an ability to schedule text, as well as support for RCS messaging and satellite communications. iOS 18 brings a new password app for managing credentials, game mode for optimizing gaming performance, and improved photo organization with topics and carousels. The Wallet app adds tap to cash for quick Apple Cash transfers. This was the evolution of the iOS. From the early days of the original iPhone to today's advanced technologies, we've seen how each version of iOS has brought innovations that have redefined the limits of what's possible. Until next time, subscribe to our channels and stay connected and be future ready.